5-star copy all, go ahead.
Message to Observer, Alpha 3 rounds, AT delay in effect, 3 guns. Bravo 2 rounds, 2 guns, smoke on effect.
Hey, this is Andrew from the Options Millionaire Community. Thanks for watching another video of the Options Trading How-To Series, a series where we go over all subjects related to options trading from the most elementary to the most advanced and everything in between. In this video, we're going to start cranking up the technical application just a little bit and start tinkering with a few advanced strategies. This is going to be probably the most basic of the quote-unquote advanced strategies, meaning we're doing something a little bit more than just buying a call or buying a put. Today, we're going to be talking about long straddles and how to use them to make consistent profitable returns in areas of uncertainty. Now, what is a long straddle? A long straddle is where you, the trader, buys both a long call and a long put that have the same expiration and the same strike price. For example, if the stock that you were looking to buy an options contract on was priced at $100 on December 1st, you would want to buy both a call and a put at the same time for a strike price of $100 or as close as possible, so 103, 105, whatever the options chain allows. You would want to pick the expiration date within a time frame that you think a large move will be made. If you think it's going to be made this afternoon, you buy it for one day. If you think it's going to be made next week, you buy it a week or maybe 2 weeks to build yourself in a little slop. So when is the best time to buy a long straddle and how do I pick the expiration? There are two rules to follow when you want to consider entering a long straddle. One is right before an anticipated large move in price, aka right before an earnings event, right before some sort of news event. Maybe we've been consolidating all day or for a few days in anticipation of a Jay Powell speech and you think there's going to be a large move up or down. You're just not sure which direction. So you decide to enter a long straddle 5 minutes before he talks. And two, in periods of low implied volatility where you think there'll be a rapid and egregious increase in implied volatility, thus increasing both the cost of your calls and your puts simultaneously, making you more profitable. One of the main upsides of a long straddle is that you have unlimited profit potential, but limited risk. Your risk is just the cost of your calls and puts, the cost of your premium, where the profit, if the underlying, for example, were to go to zero, you would make unlimited profit on your puts. And if the underlying were to rocket upwards in perpetuity, you would make unlimited profit on your calls. The only downside on either one of those would be the losing leg of the straddle, i.e. the calls or the puts, whichever direction it's going. Now you may be asking yourself, I'm buying both a call and a put, so I'm losing money on one of those legs if the position moves up or down. How do I know when I'm going to be profitable? Well, there's a whole bunch of charts out there, mainly some that look like this from investopedia.com. Some of those can kind of be tricky, although once you dive in, you kind of understand how. But I want to focus on more of a basic visualization of a non-profitable long straddle position, a profitable upside, and a profitable downside position. We'll start out with the non-profitable or the unprofitable position. This is a sideways day, a terrible time to do a long straddle. This would actually be a great time to do a short strangle, but that's for another video. Long straddles here, your break-even point is going to be roughly here and roughly here. Now, I'm just ballparking those numbers. There are some great options calculators to actually figure out what your actual break-even point would be, but this is what I'm just going to throw as raw numbers here to give you a visual aid of what your break-even point would pretty much look like. So if you were to take a long straddle here, you would need the position to climb up through this in order for you to start becoming net profitable in that position. That means your call leg will start outpacing the decay of your put leg, thus making you profitable. And the higher this goes, the more quicker it climbs, the more profitable you'll be. And on the downside, if this position starts to climb downwards, this is your break-even point again. This is where your put premiums are outpacing the decay of your call premiums, thus making you profitable. If this position were to stay in between these lines, you would lose money. And if you held that until expiration, you would lose 100% of your premiums, thus being in a completely unprofitable position. Let's take a look at a breakout to the upside and how that would look. So let's say on this day, you expect some sort of news event to happen around this time frame right here, maybe a press conference or Jay Powell or an earnings report or something that comes out right here where you think the price is going to move up or down. You just don't really know when or how much. So you decide to take a long straddle right here. If the price stays in between these break-even points depending on your expiration, this position will expire worthless and you'll lose your money. Or the longer it stays here, the more it decays and the more money you'll lose. So your optimum play is for it to break out up or down. And let's see what happens. So you take the position, you're losing money, it's decaying, it's staying even right here in between these, and then finally, boom, you get your breakout. Now it breaks out to the upside and you start making money. It's crossed through the break-even point. The increase of the call premiums are outpacing the decrease in your put premiums, and you are making money. Not to mention, implied volatility is probably increasing here, thus further increasing your premiums, and you are making money. This would have been a fantastic time to take a long straddle, because now you've taken the risk out of the uncertainty and you've captured a move, and you don't care which way, up or down, you made money. Now we're going to take a look at a downward profitable position where the puts make you money. So let's say you enter a straddle right here, same setup. You expect there'd be some sort of news event right here where you think things are gonna go one way or the other. So you enter a long straddle and it goes and goes and goes and is now unprofitable. And then bam, finally breaks out the bottom and makes your position profitable. The increase in the put premium outpaced the decrease in the call premium, thus making you money. So that's pretty easy to understand, right? So let's talk about a few different strategies on which to deploy the long straddles. There are three different methods on which you can utilize these, in my opinion. Number one is to ride the full straddle till max profit. You take the position, you get the big move you want, things are profitable, whether up or down, and then things start to exhaust, things start to consolidate, and you think that's pretty much it for the move, so you just elect to close the entire straddle altogether and collect your money and go home. The second method is to just capture only the implied volatility increase. You're not necessarily looking for the move, you're just looking for the big uptick in implied volatility. So maybe right before you buy one a week before an earnings event, you ride the big increase. It, implied volatility goes from 8% until 20%, and you just get the increase in implied volatility and you close out the position. The third method, and probably my favorite method, is to enter the straddle right before a move of uncertainty, and then just close out the losing leg when you get the desired move. Now, what do I mean by that? So let's revisit the scenario where the call was profitable, where this position broke up. You enter the straddle here, and everything's pretty much the same as before. We hit play, things are going great. We finally break through profitability, break into profitability. We break above break even, things are going great. And you think the whole market is going to climb way higher. So right here, things are both profitable. You elect to just go ahead and close the put side of the leg. So you just go into your whatever broker you use. I use E-Trade. You would sell the put position, and now all you've got left is a call position. So now you just ride the call all the way up without any downside holding you up and continue to go up and up and up, and you just ride it just like you would a normal call position. The benefit of this is you took the uncertainty out of the position. Maybe some people thought this was going down and they bought puts and now they're getting roasted. Or maybe you were just sitting on your hands waiting and you took a call up here because you weren't sure exactly and you missed out on all this gains. Either way, this is a safer play because it takes the uncertainty out of the position. You don't know which way you're going, so you enter the straddle, this goes up, you close the put leg, and then you let the calls run. Things are great and you're making money. The biggest risk associated with what I just explained, closing with a losing leg and letting the winning leg run, is when you're wrong. When you get a false breakout and now you end up losing both legs. What do I mean by that? Let's say you entered a long straddle right here. Now this thing's chopping up. You think you get the breakout. Boom, you get above your break even. The position finally goes green. You think this is going to keep on running like the other one. So right here, you elect to close out the put side of the leg and you were going to let the call leg run. So now you're just going to hold that call. Well, you get smacked in the face and this thing immediately reverses. So now you've done that, you've closed the put side, you're holding the call leg. So when the position reverses to the downside, now all you're doing is holding a losing call. You're not in a straddle anymore because you closed the put. Now all you've got is a losing position. Now you've lost both on the put leg and you've lost on the call leg, thus removing the benefit of a straddle. That is just one risk. So if you are going to play the position where you're going to close at the losing leg, you have to be very certain that the move is confirmed and is going to run. Otherwise, you risk this, a reversal, closing your position. All right, so I'm going to show you all how to set one of these up in E-Trade. Here is the E-Trade options train now. As you can see, pretty straightforward. You've got the expirations up here. You've got the strikes. If you want to know more about how to trade overarching options in E-Trade, watch this video right here. Link down in the description as well. So let's just say today is November 21st, that you think by November 24th, there's going to be a large move. So you'll come down here, you'll select the at the money contract. We close at 460 8.89. So the at-the-money contract will be at 469. All right, so today is November 21st. Let's say that you think by November 24th, there is going to be a precipitous move. Either way, you just don't know which one. So I would just go ahead and open up one of the options order book by selecting this premium right here, which is the 469. It's going to bring up this screen right here. And first, I want to come up to the selection arrow and bring down and select straddle. And then I want to select the appropriate expirations. So I'll come up here and select November 24th. 469, call puts, both being bought. And you see the total price of these is $397 on the bid each, which gives me a $400 per contract. And all this is an addition of $201 and $196 equals $397. That's the total cost of the call premium and the put premium. And that gives you the total, $399 per contract. Nothing too crazy, right? Now, going back to what I said, you can close the position and let the winning leg run. What I would do is, after I'm already in this position, I would just go to my position and elect to close it. It would bring up this very similar order form. I would come over here, and let's say the position's going up. I would close out the put side by Xing out the call, bringing up the put side of things, and I would hit preview and send and close out the put side of things. Now, that would just leave me the remaining call leg, and I'll let that baby run. Nothing too crazy, right? There's not really much to entering them or executing a long strangle. In fact, I think long straddles are a perfect way for the new options trader or for just maybe an experienced options trader that's never gone outside of long calls, long puts. It's a great way for them to start getting into more advanced strategies because long straddles are just a tiptoe into the spread environment where you start thinking about managing multiple positions as one setup. And then once you start figuring out long straddles, you can start to dive into short strangles and then some put spreads or credit spreads to start taking advantage of some theta plays and premium collecting positions that make you money. Anyway, y'all, that is all I got for you. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you're new to the channel, please hit that like button and the subscribe button so you get notifications for all of our how-to series coming up this fall, as well as my Monday, Wednesday, Friday live streams where we do live streams all morning long, sometimes even into the afternoon if the market depends on it, and you can learn a little bit something from a live trading standpoint. If y'all are looking for some good hoodie material, come over to the theoptionsmillionaire.com. It's our merch store. Grab you one of our awesome hoodies. We've got some great deals coming up here for the holidays. Be on the lookout for that. If you want to be a part of great Discord, come down there and hit the link down in the description. Enter over there with us and learn. We have a great educational resource that we focus on communal learning, not about YOLOing or emotions, but about teaching each other something, bouncing ideas off each other, and coming to a standpoint on learning. I appreciate you taking the time to watch this video. Once again, this is Andrew with the Options Millionaire Community. I'm out.